स्वागत है आपका देवभूमि दर्शन पर।
परेड पर आने वाले अगले अधिकारी हैं लेफ्टिनेंट जनरल राज शुक्ला, परम विशिष्ट सेवा मेडल, युद्ध सेवा मेडल, सेना मेडल, एड डी कैंप, जनरल ऑफिसर कमांडिंग इन चीफ आर्मी ट्रेनिंग कमांड।
Lieutenant General Raj Shukla is a graduate of the National Defense Academy Kharakwasla and the Indian Military Academy Dehradun. He was commissioned into the Regiment of Artillery in December 1982. In a career spanning four decades, the general officer has seen extensive service in the field. He commanded a medium regiment in the Eastern and Desert Theater, an infantry brigade in counter-insurgency operations, an infantry division along the line of control in the valley, and a corps along the western borders. An alumnus of the Defence Services Staff College, Wellington, College of Defence Management, Secunderabad, and National Defence College, New Delhi, the general officer has served two tenures at the Military Operations Directorate, dealing with the doctrines and force structuring, and till recently was the Director General Perspective Planning at Army Headquarters, addressing issues relating to military future and force modernization. He has also been the Commandant of the Indian Army's prestigious training establishment and think tank, the Army War College, MAU. The General Officer has attended various prestigious courses apart from doing the mandatory basic courses, to include the Defence Services Staff College, the Senior Command Course, Long Defence Management Course, and a course on BMP-2 in erstwhile USSR. An aviator and also a recipient of the Yuddha Seva Medal and the Sena Medal, General Shukla has an abiding interest in strategic military affairs. He has authored numerous articles and publications and lectured in various seminars in India and abroad. He is currently a visiting fellow at the Center for Land Warfare Studies, New Delhi. He took over as the General Officer Commanding in Chief, Army Training Command on 1st May 2020.
जनरल ऑफिसर कमांडिंग इन चीफ आर्मी ट्रेनिंग कमांड महोदय आपके बाएं ओर से परेड मैदान की ओर आ रहे हैं.
इफ द हैंड एट द हेल्म इज स्ट्रॉन्ग द शिप कैन स्टीयर द रफेस्ट सीज एंड दैट इज व्हाट इज फोर्ज्ड हियर एट द इंडियन मिलिट्री एकेडमी स्ट्रॉन्ग एंड प्रोफेशनल मिलिट्री लीडर्स. Ladies and gentlemen, Lieutenant General Raj Shukla, Param Vishisht Seva Medal, Yuddha Seva Medal, Sena Medal, AD Camp, General Officer Commanding in Chief, Army Training Command.
General Slav! Slav! Just!
Ladies and gentlemen, Shri Pushkar Singh Dhame, the Chief Minister of Uttarakhand, will shortly join us for the passing out parade, autumn term 2021. Falling arrows of the Indian braves, fighting for the land that was rightfully theirs. Many years have gone, but their spirits are still strong as they give their dreams to the next generations of young Indian braves. Ladies and gentlemen, Lieutenant General Gurmeet Singh, Param Vishisht Seva Medal, Uttam Yudh Seva Medal, Ati Vishisht Seva Medal, Vishisht Seva Medal, retired, the Honorable Governor of Uttarakhand will shortly join us and grace the occasion.
परेड अब आज के निरीक्षण अधिकारी महोदय का स्वागत करेगी। आज के निरीक्षण अधिकारी हैं भारत के प्रथम नागरिक एवं राष्ट्रपति श्री रामनाथ कोविंद।
अ लॉयर बाय प्रोफेशन ही हैज बीन द गवर्नर ऑफ द स्टेट ऑफ बिहार बिफोर ही टुक ओवर द हाईएस्ट कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल ऑफिस। Shri Kovind brings to the office a rich experience of working across the spectrum of republic from the grassroots to the apex court and parliament. He has been an ardent champion of equality in society and integrity in public life. Shri Kovind was born on 1st October 1945 at village Paronk in Kanpur district of Uttar Pradesh. Coming from a family of modest means, his beginning was humble. He attended school and college in Kanpur. He first studied commerce for bachelor's and then attained his law degree from Kanpur University. Shri Kovind was enrolled as an advocate with the Bar Council of Delhi in 1971. He served as counsel of the Union Government in the Delhi High Court from 1977 to 1978. He rose to become an advocate on record with the Supreme Court of India. From 1980 to 1993, he was standing counsel for the Union Government in the Supreme Court. Under the Free Legal Aid Society of New Delhi, he also provided pro bono aid to the weaker sections of the society, especially women and the poor. Shri Kovind was elected as a member of the Rajya Sabha, the upper house of parliament from Uttar Pradesh, effective from April 1994. He served two consecutive terms of 6 years each till March 2006. Serving on numerous parliamentary committees, he gathered in-depth experience in governance. He addressed the United Nations General Assembly on 22nd October 2003 as a member of the Indian delegation. Shri Kovind is an ardent advocate of education as a tool for social empowerment. He actively supports greater participation of women in nation building and has consistently called for the society to create more opportunities for the deprived sections, especially the disabled and the orphans. He served as a member on the board of management of the Dr. B.R. Ambedkar University, Lucknow, and also a member on the board of governors of the Indian Institute of Management, Kolkata. Shri Kovind was appointed Governor of Bihar on 8th August 2015. His term as a governor received all-round appreciation for holding the values of the Constitution. He, in his capacity as a Chancellor, introduced several reforms and modern technology in the working of state universities and also brought transparency in the appointment of Vice-Chancellors. He earned respect from leaders of all political parties for his statesmanship, sagacity, and adhering to democratic ethos. Shri Kovind's achievement as a governor burnished his credentials as a candidate for presidency in 2017. After his election to the highest constitutional office, he has discharged his duties as the first citizen of India with foresight and humility. He has paid state visits to 28 countries till December 2019, enhancing India's global outreach and footprints. As the President of India, he received the highest state honors from 6 countries, namely Madagascar, Equatorial Guinea, Eswatini, Croatia, Bolivia, and Republic of Guinea. As the Supreme Commander of the Armed Forces of India in May 2018, President Kovind made a historic visit to the troops deployed at Kumar Post in Siachen Glacier, the highest battlefield in the world. He is an avid reader and has keen interest in books on politics and social change, law, history, and spirituality. Shri Ramnath Kovind was sworn in as the 14th President of India on 25th July 2017.
निरीक्षण अधिकारी महोदय शौर्य मार्ग से परेड मैदान की ओर आ रहे हैं।
Ladies and gentlemen, you will soon hear the fanfare heralding the arrival of today's reviewing officer. May I request you all to please rise and those in uniform to salute when the national anthem is being played to salute the Honorable President of India.
देवियों और सज्जनों, जब राष्ट्रपति महोदय को सलामी देने के लिए राष्ट्रगान बजे तो कृपया स्थिर अवस्था में खड़े हो जाएं एवं वर्दीधारी सल्यूट करें।
Ladies and gentlemen, Shri Ramnath Kovind, the Honorable President of India.
Yeah. श्रीमान भारतीय सैन्य अकादमी 74 जेंटलमैन गेट परेड पर
माननीय अतिथिगण, अब निरीक्षण अधिकारी परेड का निरीक्षण करने जा रहे हैं। उनके साथ हैं भारतीय सैन्य अकादमी के समादेशक एवं परेड कमांडर।
द पासिंग आउट परेड द कॉन्सेप्ट इज टेकन फ्रॉम द सॉवरन्स परेड एट सैंडहर्स्ट टू मार्क द कमिशनिंग ऑफ जेंटलमैन कैडेट्स एज ऑफिसर्स। It is endeavored that all service chiefs review this parade at least once in their tenure besides the supreme commanders. The Indian Military Academy has been fortunate to have 6 presidents as the reviewing officers for the passing out parades till date. In December 1956, the reviewing officer was Dr. Rajendra Prasad. Dr. Sarvapalli Radhakrishnan came to us in December 1962. The passing out parade of December 1976 was reviewed by Shri Fakhruddin Ali Ahmed. Shri R. Venkataraman came to the Indian Military Academy in June 1992. The passing out parade of December 2006 was reviewed by Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Srimati Pratibha Devi Singh Patil was here as the reviewing officer in June 2011. And today, on this historic date of 11 December 21, we have the Honorable President of India, Sri Ramnath Kovind, as the reviewing officer for the passing out parade, autumn term 2021. Ladies and gentlemen, you can see the adjutant Major Utsav on his grey charger, Zoravar. The academy adjutant astride his charger is a symbol of authority and discipline. an alumnus of the National Defence Academy Kharagwasla and the Indian Military Academy Dehradun, Major Utsav was commissioned into the 8th Battalion, the Rajputana Rifles, on 12th December 2009. The officer has been a company commander at the world's highest battlefield, Siachen Glacier, where he was awarded with the General Officer Commanding in Chief Commendation Card. He has served on a United Nations peacekeeping mission in South Sudan. The officer has done his cross attachment with the Mechanized Infantry Battalion at the Western Borders and has also been a platoon commander at Cadets Training Wing, College of Military Engineering, Pune. A graduate of Defence Services Staff College Wellington, Major Utsav assumed the appointment of Adjutant, Indian Military Academy on 22nd June 2021. Ladies and gentlemen, there are three military bands on parade today. They are the Indian Military Academy Band, Bengal Engineer Group and Center Band, and the Garhwal Rifles Regimental Center Band. They are being conducted by Subedar Major Dayaram Joshi of the Indian Military Academy Band.
भारतीय सैन्य अकादमी को पहला निशान द किंग कलर 18 नवंबर 1934 को प्रदान किया गया। देश की आजादी 10 दिसंबर 1965 को भारत के तत्कालीन राष्ट्रपति डॉक्टर सर्वपल्ली राधाकृष्णन ने अकादमी को निशान प्रदान किया। अकादमी का नया निशान 15 दिसंबर 1976 को भारत के तत्कालीन राष्ट्रपति श्री फखरुद्दीन अली अहमद द्वारा प्रदान किया गया था। इसी दिन पुराने निशान को ऐतिहासिक चेटवुड भवन में यादगार चिन्ह का स्थान मिला। परेड इस समय विजय भारत की धुन पर मार्च कर रही है। नौजवानों का ये जोश, उनका उत्साह, एक साथ उठते ये हाथ, एक साथ बढ़ते ये कदम, उभरा हुआ सीना प्रमाणित करता है इस बात को कि देश सुरक्षित है इन हाथों में।
The number of our alumni who were decorated in war is legendary. Most of them have had their baptism in fire in the wars since independence. Some where blizzard and snowstorms rule. Some where the wind blows full of sand. Some where the waves hold arguments with the sky. And some in the uncharted space above. But like professional soldiers, they were conscious of the hazards of the profession they had chosen and were aware of the contribution they were making to safeguard the sovereignty of our nation.
देवियों और सज्जनों, जब भारतीय सैन्य अकादमी का निशान आपके सामने से गुजरे तो कृपया खड़े होकर निशान को सम्मान दें एवं वर्दीधारी सल्यूट करें.
Ladies and gentlemen, you will notice that the first contingent approaching the saluting dais is carrying a red flag. This is the Chief of Army Staff banner which is presented every term to the champion company and therefore it has the proud privilege of being a part of the first contingent on parade. Ladies and gentlemen, the first gentleman cadet leading the parade is Battalion Under Officer Tushar Sabra. He is followed by a contingent of battalion appointments being led by Academy Under Officer Mukul Thakur. Behind them is the first contingent, the champion company of the previous term, proudly being led by Senior Under Officer Satyam Singh Parmar. The second contingent, ladies and gentlemen, is being led by Senior Under Officer Pranjal Kapil. The third contingent is being led by Senior Under Officer Saurav Kumar. The fourth contingent, ladies and gentlemen, is being led by Senior Under Officer Anmol Kanav. The Nishan Toli, proudly carrying the Indian Military Academy colors, is being led by Senior Under Officer Akash Singh, and the escorts are Company Sergeant Major Tushar Shahi and Company Sergeant Major Akshat Chauhan. The fifth contingent is being led by Senior Under Officer Anirudh Singh. The sixth contingent, ladies and gentlemen, is being led by Senior Under Officer Dhruv Thakkar. The seventh contingent is being led by Senior Under Officer Lal Rinama Silo. The 8th contingent, ladies and gentlemen, is being led by Senior Under Officer Shivam Kashyap. Leading the last contingent is Battalion Under Officer Sange Penden Dorji. Bringing up the rear of the parade is the Academy Cadet Adjutant Anmol Gurung, marching all by himself. Ladies and gentlemen, at the end, mounted on his charger is the adjutant of the Indian Military Academy, Major Utsav.
कदम से कदम मिलाकर चलते इन वीरों का आज यही उद्घोष है. बाधाएं आती हैं आए, घिरे प्रलय की घोर घटाएं. पांव के नीचे अंगारे, सिर पर बरसे यदि ज्वालाएं. निज हाथों से हंसते हंसते आग लगाकर चलना होगा. कदम मिलाकर चलना होगा, कदम मिलाकर चलना होगा.
लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, द परेड इज नाउ मार्चिंग ऑन द इंस्पायरिंग ट्यून ऑफ सारे जहां से अच्छा, फॉर्मली नोन एज तरानाए हिंद, द एंथम ऑफ द पीपल ऑफ हिंदुस्तान. This is an Urdu patriotic song written by the renowned Urdu poet Muhammad Iqbal and was then arranged for the military band by Shri A. Lobo. In all nations and at all times, martial music has accompanied feats of arms serving the twofold purpose of inspiring the troops to fight and as a method of conveying orders. It was used in times of battles as means of invoking that grand passion which the fiercest of oration could not.
देवियों और सज्जनों, देश के बाहर हो या भीतर, युद्ध काल हो या शांति काल, सशस्त्र सेना का काम निरंतर जारी रहता है और उसकी महत्ता कभी कम नहीं होती। सशस्त्र सेना ही आज देश की सबसे गौरवशाली संस्था है। भारतीय सैन्य अकादमी निर्माण करती है देश के इन भावी कर्णधारों का, जो न केवल दुश्मनों से जूझते हैं बल्कि देश के सम्मुख आई किसी भी परिस्थिति का सामना करते हैं। अकादमी ने अवसर दिया है इन नौजवानों को कुछ कर दिखाने का, देश के लिए मर मिटने का, नए कीर्तिमान स्थापित करने का। युद्ध के दौरान ये ही नौजवान अपने साथ साथ कई और सैनिकों की रक्षा का दायित्व संभालते हैं। फिर एक दिन इन्हीं की सांस बन जाती है देश की धड़कन, इनके कदम बन जाते हैं देश का विकास और इन्हीं का खून बन जाता है देश का रक्षक।
Ladies and gentlemen, you can now see the adjutant moving to take his position at the western end of the drill square. The adjutant is mounted on his grey charger, Zoravar. The historic Chetwood building that you see in its entire splendor in front of you is named after Field Marshal Sir Philip Wodehouse Chetwood, who inaugurated the Indian Military Academy on 10th December 1932 and gave us on that day the abiding touchstone of leadership and soldiering, the Chetwood Credo. The safety, honor and welfare of your country come first, always and every time. The honor, welfare and comfort of the men you command come next. Your own ease, comfort and safety come last, always and every time.
आगे बढ़िया।
Ladies and gentlemen, in a short while from now, the parade will reform and move forward in review order for presentation of awards and for the address of the Honorable Reviewing Officer. Once the salute is being given, you all are requested to kindly rise for the national anthem. Ladies and gentlemen, now the presentation ceremony for the award winners will take place. The award winners for autumn term 2021 are the Sword of Honor awarded to the gentleman cadet adjudged overall best amongst the passing out course. The gold medal awarded to the gentleman cadet standing first in the overall order of merit of the passing out course. The winner of Sword of Honor and gold medal, Academy Cadet Adjutant Anmol Gurung. The silver medal awarded to the gentleman cadet standing second in the overall order of merit of the passing out course. The winner is Battalion Under Officer Tushar Sapra. The bronze medal awarded to the gentleman cadet standing third in the overall order of merit of the passing out course. The winner is Battalion Cadet Adjutant Ayush Ranjan. The technical graduate course silver medal awarded to the gentleman cadet standing first amongst the technical graduates of the passing out course. The winner is Junior Under Officer Kunal Chobisa. The Bangladesh medal for the best gentleman cadet standing first amongst the gentleman cadets from friendly foreign countries. Winner is Battalion Under Officer Sange Penden Dorji from Bhutan. The Chief of Army Staff banner presented to the Champion Company of Autumn Term 2021. The winner is Karen Company. Ladies and gentlemen, if you take your attention towards your left, you will see that the Chief of Army Staff banner is now being returned to the Academy by Junior Under Officer Abhishek Rajwanshi of Dograi Company. It shall be presented to the Champion Company of Autumn Term 2021.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, you can see that a banner carrier is now being slung across the right shoulder of Senior Under Officer Anmol Kanav of Karen Company to enable him to receive the coveted Chief of Army Staff banner. The Sword of Honor, ladies and gentlemen, is the most coveted recognition that a gentleman cadet aspires to possess. It is given for the best overall performance by a gentleman cadet in military training, academics, sports, and extracurricular activities. The Sword of Honor has become a symbol signifying best of the best. The tradition was started with the first course, the Pioneers, when gentleman cadet Smith Dunn, who later became the army chief of the then Burmese army, was awarded with the sword in 1934. Ladies and gentlemen, now Subedar Major Tek Chand, Subedar Major Drill, will accompany the Honorable Reviewing Officer for the prize distribution ceremony. May I request the Honorable President to kindly come and felicitate the award winners of Autumn Term 2021. Winner of the Sword of Honor and Gold Medal, Academy Cadet Adjutant Anmol Gurung. Winner of Silver Medal, Battalion Under Officer Tushar Sapra. Winner of Bronze Medal, Battalion Cadet Adjutant Ayush Ranjan. Winner of Technical Graduate Course Silver Medal, Junior Under Officer Kunal Chobisa. Winner of Bangladesh Medal for Best Gentleman Cadet from Friendly Foreign Country, Battalion Under Officer Sange Penden Dorji from Bhutan. Winner of Chief of Army Staff Banner, Karen Company. Ladies and gentlemen, the medal winners are now marching back to take their positions. It is indeed a proud moment for them as well as for all those who have been associated with their training here. And of course, their happy, proud and elated parents.
पुरस्कार विजेता अब परेड पर अपना स्थान ले रहे हैं। अपने इस प्रदर्शन के लिए न केवल जेंटलमैन कैडेट्स अपितु उनके प्रशिक्षक और भारतीय सैन्य अकादमी का स्टाफ भी गौरव का अनुभव कर सकते हैं। इस सत्र के चीफ ऑफ आर्मी स्टाफ बैनर के विजेता हैं कैरन कंपनी। इस कंपनी के जेंटलमैन कैडेट्स के लिए भी यह गौरवान्वित होने का अवसर है। यह बैनर इस कंपनी के जेंटलमैन कैडेट्स को अगले सत्र तक लैनियार्ड दाहिने कंधे पर लगाने का विशेषाधिकार प्रदान करता है।
Ladies and gentlemen, the primary aim of this institution is to present to the nation strong and daring military leaders. Undoubtedly, the institution can take justifiable pride in the fact that its alumni have brought glory to themselves and their alma mater on the battlefield time and again. The number of gallantry awards won by our alumni is ample testimony to this fact. Ladies and gentlemen, the Honorable Reviewing Officer will now address the parade.
Governor of Uttarakhand, Lieutenant General Gurmeet Singh Ji, Chief Minister Sri Pushkar Singh Dhami Ji, General Officer Commanding in Chief, Army Training Command, Lieutenant General Raj Shukla Ji, esteemed guests from friendly foreign countries, proud parents, and gentlemen cadets of the passing out course. We gather here today when the nation is yet to come out of the shock of the untimely demise of General Bipin Rawat, the Chief of Defence Staff. As you know, 12 others, including General Rawat's wife, Srimati Madhulika Rawat ji, were also killed in the chopper crash. General Rawat was an extraordinary military leader, and his death creates a void that cannot be filled. Uttarakhand was his home, and he was trained at the Indian Military Academy. Here, he was awarded the Sword of Honor for his exceptional skills. But for the tragedy, he would have been among us here today, looking at the passing out parade with delight and pride for the cadets. General Rawat added to the glory of the IMA, which is an institution with an inspiring tradition. Before him, Field Marshal K.M. Kariyappa, Field Marshal Sam Manekshaw, and many other extraordinary warriors and strategists began their journey here as young cadets and potential leaders. Some of them laid down their lives for the safety and honor of our nation. The IMA is acclaimed worldwide for its nearly 9 decades of history and heritage. Its buildings and sprawling campus are impressive indeed. It gives me pleasure to see before me the batch of 387 gentlemen cadets who would shortly embark on their journey of a life characterized by valor and wisdom. I am sure they will carry forward the rich legacy of this academy. I appreciate the immaculate turnout and an impressive display of drill. This parade comprises cadets from all parts of India and from diverse communities, as also from 10 friendly foreign countries. This is indeed a true manifestation of our unity, as also of our plural society. Gentlemen cadets, Your training here equips you to face the challenges that await you. As commissioned officers, you will be expected to blend knowledge, skills and professional application. You must internalize the Chatwood motto inscribed in your academy. All of you know the motto very well. Yet, I find it so good that I would like to repeat it for the benefit of all the cadets passing out today. The motto reads, and I quote, "The safety, honor, and welfare of your country come first, always and every time. The honor, welfare, and comfort of the men you command come next. Your own ease, comfort, and safety come last, always and every time." Gentlemen cadets, you will have the authority to lead men into battle. At the same time, you will also be expected to uphold the admiration and trust that your uniform evokes amongst fellow countrymen. You must always remain mindful that your actions will influence the outcome of military operations. Your decisions will have an impact on the lives of men under your command, and your dedication to services will have a multifaceted impact on our country. The challenges that our great nation faces today are defined by a complex security environment at the regional and global level. You must, therefore, keep in mind that physical and mental toughness alone will not equip you to tackle modern day threats to the country. As military leaders, you will have to develop a strategic mindset, cultivate an adaptive temperament, and acquire the mental resilience essential to hone the skills required for military leadership. You must be prepared to deal with the unexpected challenges that the profession of arms shall present before you at various junctures of your service. Gentlemen cadets, advancement in technology has often been driven by military dynamics. The battlefield today presents multidimensional situations. Armed forces across the world are heavily reliant on use of technology to deter or defeat the enemy's fighting capability. As modern-day military leaders, you must embrace this technological shift and understand the seamless synergy required between men and machines. It is therefore imperative that you develop sound scientific temperament and include the desire and passion to adopt technology and innovation. I feel happy to see the gentlemen cadets from friendly foreign countries of Afghanistan, Bhutan, Maldives, Myanmar, Nepal, Sri Lanka, Tajikistan, Tanzania, Turkmenistan, and Vietnam here today. We cherish the special bond between our nations, and it is a matter of great pride for India to have such fine officers and gentlemen from friendly foreign countries graduating today. I am sure that you will preserve the unique bond of friendship forged with your colleagues and instructors during your training here at the IMA. Gentlemen cadets, I once again congratulate you on the successful completion of your training at the IMA and wish you a very bright future marked by success and glory. Your service and dedication as soldiers and leaders of men shall add to the strength of a peaceful, independent, and democratic India. On this occasion, let us recall the iconic status acquired by one of the many illustrious alumni of the Academy, General Bipin Rawat, who by dint of his hard work emerged as the role model of solidarity conduct for the future generation. Our flag shall always fly high because brave men like you will preserve and protect its honor. I also extend my heartiest congratulations to the proud families of the cadets passing out today. Thank you. Jai Hind.
देवियों और सज्जनों, भारतीय सैन्य अकादमी का निशान अब परेड मैदान से बाहर ले जाया जाएगा। आप सभी से निवेदन है कि जब परेड निशान को सलामी दे तो आप कृपया खड़े हो जाएं एवं वर्दीधारी सल्यूट करें। Ladies and gentlemen, you will see the honor and pride of the Indian Military Academy, that is the colors shouldered by the gentlemen cadets of the passing out course being carried off the parade ground. The gentlemen cadets in the Nishan Toli have displayed exemplary skills in drill, bearing and turnout. It is a matter of great honor and privilege for them to be carrying the colors of the Indian Military Academy. I am a warrior. Fighting is my dharma. Ladies and gentlemen, the gentlemen cadets of the passing out course are now reforming to take formal leave from the academy, which has been their home for more than a year. Ladies and gentlemen, if you look behind the passing out course, you will see gentlemen cadets of the second term take their position at the Chetwood corridor to salute the passing out course as a mark of honor and respect to their seniors.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, very shortly, three helicopters from the 660 and 661 Army Aviation Squadron will fly past the saluting dais in cyclone formation to honor the success of the passing out course as the passing out gentlemen cadets approach the Antim Pag. The formation is being led by Lieutenant Colonel Vikas Singh, followed by Lieutenant Colonel Chetan Kaushik Sena Medal and Major Sanjay Rangwani. We along with them wish the gentlemen cadets of the passing out course good fortune and glorious years of service to the nation in keeping with the highest traditions of the Academy and the Indian Army.
देवियों और सज्जनों, अब ये जेंटलमैन कैडेट्स भारतीय सैन्य अकादमी से विधिपूर्वक विदा ले रहे हैं। धीमी गति से मार्च करते ये वीर चेटवुड भवन में प्रवेश से पहले अंतिम पग को पार करेंगे।
अंतिम पग और द लास्ट स्टेप इज इम्प्रिंटेड ऑन थ्री मेन एंट्रेंसेज ऑफ चेटवुड बिल्डिंग फ्रॉम द ड्रिल स्क्वायर। This is a symbolic step which the gentlemen cadets take to pass into the portals of the Chetwood Hall as officers. This is a moment no officer commissioned in the Indian Army is likely to forget. It remains with him as a treasured moment not only throughout his career but his entire life. Should old acquaintance be forgot and never brought to mind, should old acquaintance be forgot and days of auld lang syne. This is the tune to which all officers in the army pass out, whether it be from the Indian Military Academy Dehradun or the Officers Training Academy Chennai. The tune carries special significance as recollected by Lieutenant Irwin S. Tross in 1953. My heart was heavy as the lilting strains of Auld Lang Syne filled my ears. I knew that I was closing a chapter in my life, the like of which I would never see again. This melodious tune, the lyrics of which were composed by Robert Burns in 1978, has never failed to bring back memories to many minds and nostalgia to many hearts. Translated into English, these Scottish words literally mean old long since. Ladies and gentlemen, as the apostle of discipline, the presence of the adjutant for the passing out parade is in accordance with the customs and traditions of the Academy. As per records, the adjutant of the Indian Military Academy appeared on horseback for the very first time in 1951. Ever since then, the adjutants have very rarely walked on the drill square. They've appeared on their traditional grey chargers almost every time they're required on parade. Ladies and gentlemen, the adjutant of the Indian Military Academy will now give a salute to the reviewing officer, bringing to a formal end the passing out parade, autumn term 2021. Ladies and gentlemen, in a short while from now, three helicopters will fly past the saluting dais, displaying the National, the Army, and the Indian Military Academy flags. Ladies and gentlemen, the band is now leaving the parade ground on the tunes of Jahan Dal Dal Par. This song has been arranged for military band by Major Mahendra Das N.K. The tune for the first time was played at the beating retreat in the year 2014 at Vijay Chowk, New Delhi. You all are requested to please remain seated till the reviewing officer leaves the parade ground.
माननीय उपस्थित गण, आपसे निवेदन है कि निरीक्षण अधिकारी के चेटवुड भवन में प्रवेश करने तक आप कृपया बैठे रहें।
Ladies and gentlemen, you are requested to follow the ushers who will guide you to the enclosures of the respective battalions using the road onto your left, that is the Shaurya Marg.
आपसे निवेदन है कि आप सभी अशरर्स के साथ चलें, जो आपको आपके ठीक बाईं ओर स्थित शौर्य मार्ग से होते हुए पिपिंग समारोह की ओर ले जाएंगे।
I am a soldier. I fight where I am told, and I win where I fight. Ladies and gentlemen, we hope you all enjoyed the parade as much as we did organizing it for you. And until we meet next, keep the flame of faith alive. धन्यवाद, जय हिंद।
बने रहिए पहाड़ से मैदान की हर खबर के लिए देवभूमि दर्शन के साथ।